Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today I'm going to do a quick review of a Procolored F8 Panda A4 DTF printer. I have a repair shop, so if a printer ends up here, probably something not going right. So my review will be objective and brutal. Just satisfy lawyers. This is review only for one printer I saw, not representing the whole brand. And this is only my personal opinion. Viewer description is advised. Okay, this is the model, I believe. Here's major functions trying to sell. Optimized chipset. What's talking about is talking about add-on card to manage the ink flow. A4 is 7 minutes. Yeah, that's for sure. It has this detection system, which is pretty cool. It detects if your film is wrinkled up or not. We're going to see all of those features in my review. It prints on rolls, and it's like a mini roll. And it's 210 millimeter wide. It has, it called the siphon circulation. Actually, we add a wide pump. Auto clean print head. This is really cool. Twice a day, it's going to take 1 mL of ink from the capping station. And we're going to see that. The print on demand. So what it means, including its own RIP software. And this compare is Gen 2 with Gen 1. Which we're going to see the Gen 2 today.
The main switch is in the back, and here's the A4 rolls. And here's the white ink circulation system.
You can see the tank has a mixer, and then you got the two tubes, one in and one out.
It doesn't have this. I add this in. This is a white ink filter. So the ink comes into a diaphragm pump. This is the original pump.
It's a 24-volt diaphragm pump. The original pump doesn't work. When I put the water in there, it pumps. But however, if I put the white ink, it doesn't. So I switch to another diaphragm pump. Supposedly, it pumps white ink out and comes to the dampers and circulates back. Oh, this drag chain is, I added to it. The OEM doesn't have this drag chain. I changed the drag chain because I need to replace the tubes. The white tubes coming in is the correct C3 size, but the Procolor uses a really thin tube to feed the white ink back. As you might know, the flow is decided by the thinnest one. This pump wasn't working, so I was wondering if it was the return tube that's too thin. Although I changed a brand new pump, the same specification. After 2 days, you can see the pump stop working again. In the tube, it's clear. That means the ink gets condensed. You see how clear it is? The pump is not working. Here's the color tank. It's just a regular barometric tank. And the color tubes are the correct size. They use dampers, so it really doesn't matter if you use a barometric tank or a regular tank. Here is where the original Epson main board and their drive board located. I really like how compact it is, and it was well designed and was put in pretty nicely. Here's the printhead safeguard system. This is really cool. It detects if your film is flat or not. If it's not, it's going to stop printing. However, I just really don't think it's needed. Normally, your printhead carriage is lower than your printhead level. So if you get a wrinkled film, it's going to stop by the carriage. My friend told me this loss of synchronization problem. You can see I started. It goes left and right, check the carriage return, and then it air out. However, if I restart again, I go over left and right and didn't air out. The timing of when it's aired out is checking the paper feed. Check the last air code. FE means the motor exceeds the paper feed speed. The paper feed sensor feeds into this driver board. So this driver board sometimes works, sometimes doesn't. If you have this problem, just restart your printer a couple times. They hook up the capping station with pump, and they pump out 1 mL of ink twice a day. The problem will be, based on my experience, the ink is going to accumulate in the pump and kill the pump. because it's using a diaphragm pump, if the pump's dead, the waste sink will not go out. Just like this unit, I already changed the pump to a new pump. But if you use this machine and find the waste cannot go out, not only check the tubes, but also check if the pump is working. Normally, diaphragm pump put more ink out per minute. However, they also have problem of clogging. So if you get clogged, it could die quickly. So I was surprised that the pump I put in died so quick, just after a couple of days. Oh, the waste pump works wonderful. However, is the white ink circulation pump. Even if it's working, it seems just cannot catch up speed. I already changed the tubes and changed it to a new pump. Eventually, I was like, let's test how much voltage this motor got. Turn the printer on, now the mixer is running. And after mixer is running, the pump should run. Here it says 12 volts. Did I do it wrong? So I took off the motor and I take a look. And I took out two motors. Here it says 24 volts. And this is the waste motor and it says 24 volts. So either they put a wrong voltage pump or their chipset is wrong. Their chipset should output at 24 volts. I don't have a 12 volts diaphragm pump, so I put a peristaltic pump. Okay, let's see. Turn it on. And the mixer is running. Problem solved. Oh, by the way, this customer was never able to print a single page after she bought it. The original problem was this printer has been in the warehouse for too long, so the ink clogged in the tube. And all other things I find out when I start fixing it. The pump in the front is the new waste pump I put it in there. Procolored has this problem, which is when the printer start cleaning, you can see the printed carriage goes left and right. And sometimes the pump was out of sync with the printhead movement. So the printhead was stuck on the platform and cannot move. You can hear the pump is running. Because it runs twice a day, when it's out of sync, you can see here, and you get a double air light. It may or may not happen. And that happened to me a couple times. You have a printer that runs for a couple of days fine, and then suddenly one day you come back, you get double error light. Think about this. You used to use the Epson's OEM mesmerizing pump to drive this. It drives the location and the suction. However, if you override it, now you cannot precisely control the position. When you get the double error light, your printhead is suspended in the air, and you come back, the printhead will be dry and dead. Okay, I pretty much covered everything I saw here. The only thing I didn't cover is their software, the RIP software. And I hope this is helpful. Please visit us at bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.